I think you're going to like this picture.
Love That Bob. Starring Bob Cummings.
Chuck, that's all from Mr. College, ma'am.
I was just looking for Uncle Bob.
Oh, well, you were following the right bait, but he's not here.
Oh, gee, I was hoping to catch a ride home.
You know, you picked a bad weekend to come home. Grandpa Collins has got your room.
Well, I'll take Mom's room. She's in Joplin.
Not anymore. Now, the boss just went to the airport to pick her up.
Oh. Boy, is Grandpa going to catch it when Mom gets a hold of him?
You think she'll still be mad?
Mad? She'll...
wring his neck. The idea of tricking me into flying to Joplin just to get me out of the way.
Oh, Margaret, he just wanted to use the house to entertain some of his old war buddies.
Has he been throwing wild parties?
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? Haven't you been home?
Well, no, Margaret, see, I had this assignment in Las Vegas.
You mean Grandpa's had the house all to himself?
Well, I guess so. See, Chuck's been away at
college.
Drive
faster. There's no telling what we may find.
Look, Margaret, see, I'm a little late for an appointment at the office, so you take the car and leave me off there, huh?
Coward.
Well, Maggie, honey. Welcome back.
Hello, Grandpa.
Gina, you stay right there, and I'll come out and help you.
I don't need any help. I've only got these two small bags.
Oh, here, honey. You just let me... I'm right in there, honey.
What?
Well, we don't lug these two big bags all the way through the house. I'll drive you around in front, and we'll walk it in style.
That's ridiculous, Grandpa.
Oh, honey, wait a minute. Oh, you're too dressed up to walk through the kitchen.
What's in there you don't want me to see?
Well, I didn't do the breakfast dishes.
Well, I've seen that. What was that?
What was what?
A chicken just flew out of the kitchen window.
You ought to speak to that man that sells you the eggs. I don't think they're strictly fresh. Agnes, run and hide in the closet.
Agnes?
Oh, Maggie, wait a minute, honey. Maggie. Oh, no, Maggie, honey. Now, look, don't scare the hens. You'll throw them off their laying schedule.
What in the world?
Now, Maggie. If I told you once, I told you 100 times to stay out of my bathwater.
Bathwater?
What do you... You know, Maggie, I just can't stand showers. So I got a good bargain on this here tub. Shot it, too.
You know I don't want you taking baths in my kitchen.
Eric, well, you don't expect me to carry this big, heavy thing all the way upstairs, do you?
Listen, I'll give you just 5 minutes to get this thing out of here, and I...
What are you doing?
My Easter hat!
Oh, now look, Maggie. Now, she didn't hurt it so much. She just antiqued it a little, see? It's real cute.
Oh, what are you doing with that animal?
Oh, Maggie, I'm so sorry. But you see, I couldn't get myself no fresh goat's milk out here. And the doctor says I need it.
But a goat in the house.
I tried keeping her in the garage, but she didn't get along with Florence.
Florence?
Yeah, you see, you got to mix the goat's milk with fresh...
No!
Yeah, that's what you mix it with.
A goat named Agnes.
You can laugh. You didn't have to clean up the mess and get rid of the livestock.
Oh, now, honey, can't you indulge an old man a few eccentricities?
Like chickens in the kitchen and a goat that ate my best new hat?
You mean that Agnes ate your hat?
You wouldn't think it was so funny if you were suddenly confronted with something like Agnes. Pamela?
Hello there, Robert.
Well, hello, Agnes. Pamela. Excuse me, I think I hear the developer bell ringing. I think.
Pamela? Is your grandmother still riding her horse around Hollywood?
Clippity-clop.
She's well, I take it.
Fit as a fiddle and ready for love. If you could just corner that elusive grandfather of yours.
Yes, he's staying at our house.
I know. When she rode out to see him yesterday, he didn't answer the bell. She bent over to peek through the keyhole and was suddenly and savagely butted by a goat.
Oh, dear.
Knocked her completely senseless. Poor goat.
The goat was not senseless?
Grandmother has spent some 60 years in the saddle, Margaret. Which brings me to the reason for my visit. When is Mr. Collins going to photograph her? She's quite anxious to return to Dodge City.
Say, why don't we have Grandpa photograph your grandmother? That would bring them together.
Capital idea. I'll have Grandmother saddle up and gallop over.
Oh, didn't you tell me she rode bareback?
Not out here. She got sunburned.
She gone?
Yeah. Say, Bob, we've just got the most marvelous idea for Grandpa to photograph Pamela's grandmother.
Oh, Margaret Gray. Hey, that... Oh, you know when he can do it?
When?
When I go to Palm Springs.
Yeah. You're going to run off again and leave me with all the problems.
Margaret, there's a medical convention at Lorizon this weekend, and I have the assignment to cover it.
Well, you can come up with a better story than that. A medical convention.
Schulte, is there a medical convention in Palm Springs this weekend?
That's right, boss.
Do I have the assignment to cover it?
You sure have, boss.
There you are.
Well, okay, I'm sorry. Bye.
Bye, sis. Schulte, did you get a hold of Jack Rather and find out how many nurses would be at that convention?
2,000, boss.
Boy, that's going to be a tough assignment, judging that beauty contest.
Ralph, son. Let me just tell you how you feel. Must have been a terrible blow coming in out of the yard and finding your women folk gone. Don't you worry there. You're a good looker. You won't have no trouble. No. Well, now, I'll tell you what. I'll put you out in the yard, and you scratch up a few greens. And after a little while, I'll drive you down to the beach. See if you can't strike up a friendship with a cute little seagull down there. Good advice, Ralph. If she flies out to sea, don't try to follow her, son. Anyway, Josh Collins talking.
Hello, Josh. I heard you was in town for the convention.
Who's this?
Charlie Henley, you old Missouri mule.
Well, Charlie,
you old Los Angeles smog smeller. Hey, Josh, I was just sitting here looking at a picture of us with Teddy Roosevelt back in Dodge City. Boy, you sure was a handsome devil. Remember when you used to date a different girl every day?
Yeah.
And two more at night?
Yeah.
You don't do that no more, do you?
No, I had to give up the day shift. My tennis lessons. Say, Charlie, what do you think about I fixing up a little date with a couple of cuties for tonight? And you? Oh, hold it, Charlie. Yes, sir. What is it?
Grandpa, I can't find my electric razor. Did you use it?
No. Oh, yeah, I got rid of that.
You got rid of it?
You can use my straight edge, son. It's in my toolkit. Charlie, you see, my grandson has got this wonderful photography studio. And I want to tell you, them models of his are just built like... Hold it, Charlie. sense, then.
Grandpa, why'd you get rid of my electric razor?
Well, for your own protection. I no more started to shave with that thing, and it clogged up with lather.
Lather?
Oh. Well, that worked the worst of it. When I put that thing under the faucet to wash it out, it darn near blew me out of the bathroom.
Still there, Grandpa? Where'd you put it?
But what, son?
My electric razor.
You mean to tell me you're fixing to use that in spite of my warning?
Well, yes, Grandpa. There is no reason why
I tell you got an awful muley streak there, ain't you, son?
But, Grandpa,
listen and learn, son. Listen and learn. Make that your motto. You got a nice shaped head there, boy. Try to see if you can't get something to soak into it.
Oh, all right, Grandpa.
You still there, Charlie boy?
Yeah, George.
I was just talking to my granddaughter's boy. Yeah, he's nice enough. Only he ain't the brightest lad that ever come down the pike. Gee, what was I talking about?
He was talking about lining up a couple of good-looking models for tonight.
Oh, I was? Well, maybe I can line up a couple for you, too. Charlie, just hold it. What is it, boy?
Grandpa, have you seen my bongo drums?
No.
Are you sure?
Well, sure, I'm sure.
But, Grandpa, I distinctly remember leaving them.
Charlie, I'm going to have to call you back. This boy's just pestering the daylight out of me. All right, fine. All right, Sandell, let's get it off your chest. Tell me once and for all, what is it?
My bongos. They're two round wooden drums. They're attached together.
Don't you think about seeing your bangles? That I would have... Oh! Oh, you mean them two little pickle barrels there?
Yeah. Grandpa, you didn't put pickles in them, did you?
No, son. Of course not. They was too little.
Thank goodness.
Just perfect for curing sauerkraut.
Sauerkraut?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Grandpa, where are they?
Oh, no, you don't. You go fill it up on sauerkraut and you'll spoil your lunch.
Oh, now, Colette, honey, I don't want to break our date, but I just must go to Palm Springs. It's very...
You care more for that convention than you do for Colette.
Listen,
I think maybe there will be pretty girls there.
Honey, girls? Now, how could you say that? It's a medical convention. Oh. Honey, only a cause as vital as the advancement of medical science could tear me from you.
But you are a photographer. Can you advance medical science?
Of course. In my own way, I hope to make several advances. You be a sweet girl and wait for me. And up.
Bobby, will you think of Colette while you are with all those doctors?
Honey, who? Oh, the doctors. Oh, yes, of course.
Am I your favorite?
You know you are.
Do you like me more than any other girl?
How could I help it? You've got more charm, more beauty. More je ne sais quoi. More. More hands.
Hi, Bob.
Oh. Hi there, Shirley. My goodness. You've been here long, have you?
Oh, long enough.
Yeah.
How did you like what Bobby said to me?
Fine, but I liked it better last night when he said it to me.
Sure.
What? Why don't you give up? Me, yes.
No, don't want to lose our heads.
You know.
Yeah.
Where's Josh at?
Excuse me. Oh.
I told you once to throw off the headline.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry, Mrs. Livingstone, but I forgot to call Grandpa. Anyway, his camera's over to our house, so you just ride over there, okay?
Nope. The horse pulled up lame on me, boy.
Oh, no.
That's these freeways out here, all that stopping and starting.
Oh, wait. I've got to pack a bag for Palm Springs anyway. I'll drive him home.
Oh, Chucky boy. Gee, you know, I wasn't able to find Charlie Haney's phone number. So I'm just going to hop into Mitchell and take a ride over to his place. He lives right here in Hollywood, son.
Okay, Grandpa. Gee, you sure I've got some wonderful pictures in this album?
Yes, indeed. Say, son. Hey, George. You know, I think there's a picture Charlie Henry's place. Right in here someplace. Seems to me I... Yes, sir. There it is. That's Charlie Henry's house. That ought to be a familiar corner to you, eh, son?
No. No, I don't recognize it.
Gee. You must not get around much, son. At their house, that's right on the northwest corner of Hollywood and Vine.
Grandpa, it doesn't look like that now.
No, I reckon Charlie's had it painted. That was when we come back from Cuba, fall of 98.
Grandpa, it's gone now.
Yeah. Yeah, and I wish I could bring it back. The fall of 98. Well, I'll tell you, we had some fun that year. Well, you tell your mom that I've gone over to see Charlie.
Well, Grandpa, wait. Wait, Grandpa. This picture's 60 years old.
You bet they don't make pictures like that nowadays.
Grandpa, wait. Grandpa, Hello?
Hello, this is Charlie Henry. Josh Henry called me back.
Oh, Mr. Henry, wait a minute. He just went out. Grandpa! Grandpa! Gee, Mr. Henley, I'm sorry I missed him. He just drove out. Say, he's heading for Hollywood and Vine. It sounds silly, but he expects to find you there on the northwest corner.
The old cook still likes to give orders, yeah? Okay, I'll be there. Bye.
Bye.
Boy, Grandpa must carry a horseshoe in his pocket.
Well, Charlie. It was nice having you to be waiting out in front for me there.
Well, I was expecting you, Josh, but I sure wasn't expecting this car. I ain't seen one like this in years.
You ain't? Well, I thought they had a lot of convertibles out here in California. You sure have fixed up the front of your house back there on the corner. I never would have known it.
Oh, don't live there no more, Josh. Sold that corner.
Oh, you did?
Yep, 1900.
Oh, Charlie. You could have gotten $2,000 for that easy. Cash money.
No, no. When I say $1,900, Josh, I don't mean cash.
Took back a second mortgage, eh? You never was much of a businessman anyway, Johnny.
No, no. You don't... what I mean... Skip it. Yeah. Well, where are we headed?
Well, we're going to my grandson's studio. Pick us up a couple of cute little models.
Poor Josh. You think a couple of good lookers want to go with a couple of old fossils?
What do you mean, old fossils? These girls is young and pretty. Thank you. Hey, Charlie. I still say we should have put on our uniforms. That's what gets the girls.
Well, do you know there's any girls to get got?
There's always a flock of females fluttering around Robbie's roost. There's a chip off the old block, you know. You best take your hat off.
Well, I don't see no females, fluttering or otherwise.
What do you call this, a potato rake? What about this in here? Hmm?
You mean we're dating a couple of pictures?
Oh, you darn fool! These here are just samples. Who keeps these women in there?
Oh, then what are we doing out here, huh? No.
I think we ought to go put on our uniforms. I want to tell you, it makes the difference between daylight...
Why don't you go on home? Bob and I have work to do.
Oh, don't you push me, you fat blonde.
Who are you calling a fat blonde?
Je vous trouve de grosse blonde.
Why, you loudmouth.
Oh,
je tendrai pour papa. Would you want to do
them two okay, you think?
Not bad, Josh.
Okay, you take the fat blonde, I'll take the loudmouth, I tell you.
I'm going to sit right here.
Well, then, so am I.
Howdy. You two gals like to step out with us two fellas?
Are you serious?
Not us. We're fun-loving boys, right, Charlie? I got my convertible parked down to the curb. Take you any place you'd like to go.
You must be joking. You wouldn't pull our legs, would you?
We're fun-loving. How about hitting the road?
No. I have other plans.
So have I.
You mean you're turning us down?
We.
Yes.
Well, maybe we...
Don't get away, girls. We'll be right back. Now, when will you learn to listen to me? If we wore our uniforms, them there girls had fell all over themselves trying to get to us.
Ah, how gosh.
Did you ever go into a USO and try to get a dance without your uniform? I'm going home. We're going to change right now.
Josh!
That's an order! Don't you forget it.
Right, this way, Miss... Oh, girls, look, has my grandfather been here?
Oh, they were two elderly gentlemen.
They tried to date you, dearie?
Yeah.
Well, they was here, all right.
Did they say where they were going?
No, but they said they'd be right back.
Aha, we got them. Come on, let's get set up for the pictures. I'll make him photograph you all afternoon.
Bob, please take me a palm.
No,
please. Oh, with you. Take me, please, please. Please.
I have...
It's Josh all over again.
Now, girls, don't you think I'd love to take you to Palm Springs? But it wouldn't be fair to you. I'm going to be busy night and day. I've got 1,000 things to take care of. 2,000 if I hold up.
Bobby, you work too hard.
That's right. Look, someday it's going to catch up with you.
Honey, you think so? Oh, you mean... Yeah. Well, let's hope not.
Where is that smooth-talking brother of mine?
He's in the studio.
Look at this. He told me he was going to Palm Springs to cover a medical convention.
2,000 nurses.
A beauty contest.
And Bob's the judge.
Well, he will need those nurses. I am going to be in Palm Springs waiting for him if I have to high-teach.
Say, you know, I... Me too.
Thank you, son.
I still say this is just a lot of nonsense.
Yeah. Well, you see. Well, howdy, girls. We're back.
Didn't you say you had a convertible?
Yes, honey.
Oh, would you handsome gentlemen drive us to Palm Springs?
Please.
Hi, Margaret. I'm on my way to the big medical convention. Bye, sis.
Bye. I hope you and Grandpa have a good time in Palm Springs.
Oh, don't you worry. What was that, Margaret?
Oh, Grandpa and his buddy left for the convention with Shirley and Colette.
What are you talking about?
Come on over here to the window and you can wave goodbye to them.
What?
Grandpa, goodbye! Have fun!
Here we will, Maggie.
Look, Grandpa! What do you think you're doing, you old goat?
Bob, I'm shocked at your attitude.
Look, Grandpa, you bring my models back here.
Can't you indulge an old man a few eccentricities?
He doesn't even know how to get to Palm Springs. He'll probably take one of those crazy shortcuts of his. Grandpa, come back here!
Fellas, this doesn't look like the road to Palm Springs.
Just keep your needle on, Blondie. We'll get there.
Of Pamela Livingstone and Grandma were played by Nancy Culp, Shirley Swanson by Joey Lansing, Colette Dubois by Lisa Gay, and Charlie Henley by Andy Clyde. This is Bill Baldwin speaking.